meeting about
which bond?
This is a $20 million, $21 million bond reissuance, lowering the interest rate.
Well,
is what it is.
So easy. Tell me something. What's the next SPLOST expiration date?
One of the two things that we voted. All right, we got three commissioners. I'd like to call the Board of Commissioners bond meeting.
SPLOST 7. Starts next summer and goes for 6 years.
Hey, we can't without Ken.
6 years.
The guy in the blue is the bond guy.
The guy got
the rubber.
Theoretically. There's no special purpose. Is there some way that we could talk about Kenny's sales taxes went to reduce the
I'd like to call this order. Do we have everyone here that we need?
We do. We've got a quorum and we've got.
We do have a quorum.
Yes, sir.
I'd like to call the special called meeting Tuesday, August 28th, Forsyth County Board of Commissioners to order at 5:08. Are there any changes to the agenda?
No, sir, Mr. Chairman.
Anyone else? No. Is there a motion to adopt the agenda as is?
Okay.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. Those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, like sign. I believe that passes unanimously. And this, I guess, goes to the county attorney.
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, thank you. This is a special called meeting, not a work session, but a meeting of the Board of Commissioners with respect to the bond refinancing that has been set in place at earlier meetings. Here on behalf of this agenda item is Roger Murray, which is the county's bond counsel, and he will be making the presentation to you today. And Roger, over to you.
Well, I'll tell you what. I'm gonna turn it over to David, who's basically gonna give you the numbers, and then I'll turn it back over to me for the formal action.
David.
Okay. Bond, as you had authorized the county manager to authorize when the bond documents and everything was ready to go to market. Mr. Deere did so yesterday. Our underwriters, Merchant Capital, went to market and sold the bond issues for this refunding. The market was good to us yesterday, and then it moved in our favor more than $100,000+ than it was on Friday, so we did quite it right yesterday.
Wow.
And then Friday was about $1.25 million, went around there, and as we ended up, the present value savings net of cost is $1,279,084, or a rate, effective rate, just over 1.58%. And it had gone up into the 160s just this past week, so it just hit it right on today. The people who would really get the credit for that work in the marketplace right now, we got a call. He's on Georgia 400, stuck in traffic from an accident. Andrew was trying to be here. I don't know if Jamie was coming as well, but for Merchant Capital, Andrew Tritt was going to be here. So I'm sort of filling in with the numbers that he sent us. So with that, we had, I think, a very successful refunding, and that is a general obligation bond backed up by the good faith of the credit of the county. One other thing I'll mention on the official statement that went out, both rating agencies did reaffirm our rating again. We again had a AAA with Moody's and Stable, and as well as a AA+ with Standard & Poor's. And that's it. Turn it back to Roger.
One other point of interest in this transaction is these are actually taxable bonds, not tax-exempt bonds. Interest rates are so low right now that we're issuing taxable bonds and we're able to refinance tax-exempt debt. And the reason we had to issue taxable bonds is the tax laws only allow you to refinance debt a certain number of times on a tax-exempt basis. And so we had to do this taxable. But I just find it pretty interesting. In any event, Ken and I drafted a bond resolution that authorizes the issuance of the bonds and the execution of the documents needed to close the transaction. And so I think we're ready for a motion and to adopt the bond resolution.
Can I ask you a question? I never thought, all the other times we we have talked about other bonds in general, and we've heard things like they can only be reissued X number of times.
Yeah, advanced refunded is the buzzword, right?
Okay, but the taxable versus non-taxable, if they had said, well, if you want to reissue these as taxable this time, you could.
The rates have never been like this before. In my 25 years, this has never been an option before. You know how the investment bankers are. They come up with any trick they can to achieve interest rate savings, and it just wasn't a viable option until now.
But you don't, on an ongoing basis, it's not like we need to look at everything that we have and say, hey, we could reissue these as taxable and somehow still save some money.
Andrew's looked at all that stuff.
Okay.
Yeah, he's looked at every deal. Yeah, every deal that's out there in terms of, you know, can it be refinanced on a tax exempt or a taxable basis. And as you know, this is what third one they've done this year, two tax exempt and this one. So.
Yeah, the key register, this is an advanced refunding. I mean, these aren't callable until 2014, I believe.
Correct.
So the money's taken, put aside in special investments until that date comes. If we were up to 2014, you can do a refunding, right?
Yeah, there's no limits on that's current versus advanced refunding. And basically, what that means is it's the time period that has to expire before you can call in the old bonds. So if you can prepay or call in the old bonds right away, it's called current refunding. And there are no limitations on the number of times you can do that. But if you have to wait for a while before you can call in the old bonds, that's an advanced refunding, and you only get one of those on a tax-exempt basis. And the reason is because you have two series of bonds outstanding until the old ones can be called in. So the IRS says, no, we don't want you to have, you know, multiple series out.
I just want to make sure, Mr. Chairman, we have documents in your agenda book, but I believe they were drafts. I just want to make sure, is this the latest and greatest right here?
Yes, it's the only difference in the final form in what you have is the interest rates have been inserted into the document.
And Roger, could you just go over very quickly the what you're asking them to approve? Just tell the board what it does.
Okay.
When they approve that, what is it also approving with that?
This authorizes the issuance of the bonds, and it authorizes the execution of the bond purchase agreement and the escrow deposit agreement and the continuing disclosure certificate. And the bond purchase agreement is the agreement pursuant to which the county agrees to sell the bonds to Merchant Capital, who in turn sells the bonds to their investors. The escrow deposit agreement, that's the agreement that governs the investment of the bond proceeds until they're used to pay off the old bonds. Because we'll take the bond proceeds, we'll buy United States Treasury obligations that will mature on the call date of the old bonds, and then we'll pay off the old bonds. And the continuing disclosure certificate, as we've discussed before, under the new Securities and Exchange Commission rules, you have to update your county financial and operating data every year, so that investors that want to buy or sell these bonds in the secondary market have updated information on the county. So that's what that document does.
And what sort of a motion?
Mr. Chairman, you know, at this point, if the board is comfortable with everything they heard, there would just be a motion to adopt the resolution regarding the, and really what I would prefer you do is just read that offset paragraph in the first page.
Mm-hmm.
A resolution providing for, yes, sir.
Mr. Chairman, I make a motion to approve the resolution providing for the issuance of $20,960,000 in aggregate principal amount of Forsyth County, Georgia taxable general obligation refunding bond series 2012 in the naming of the authenticating agent, bond registrar, paying agent for said bonds, the adoption of a form to which said bonds shall adhere, the levy of a tax sufficient to pay the principal of and interest on said bonds, the execution and delivery of said bonds, the execution and delivery of the official statement relating to said bonds, and the execution, delivery, and performance of an escrow deposit agreement, and the execution, delivery, and performance of a bond purchase agreement, finally, for all other related purposes.
Thank you.
Time sensitive?
Time sensitive.
It's a special meeting. So no time sensitive.
I'll second that.
We have a motion. We have a second. Is there any discussion? If not, please vote on the motion. Those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, like sign. There is no opposition. That passes unanimously. Are there any other items to come before this special meeting? If not, is there a motion to adjourn the special called meeting and enter into executive session?
Reconvene the work session.
So moved. We have a motion.
Second.
And we have a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. Those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, like sign. That there is no opposition. That passes unanimously.
Mr. Chairman, with respect to the work session, which is reconvened, would you allow Roger 5 minutes to get these documents signed before we begin going to executive session? We need to get these signed before he leaves.
Okay. So are we in work session?
We're in work session now, but just do some very quick signing before we go into executive.
Or do we want to take a break?
You want to do a 5 minute recess, get a sandwich, whatever.
How about a 5 minute recess from the work session? And I would ask everybody to please sign the documents.
Down 1-2, or just this?
No, do all of them.
We'll see.
All right, what I would do is this program.
I'm missing.
Yes, this is the minute of the file. As well, you guys, this is what we file.
See you.
So, what I would do is I would get all this tonight.
It's a special club we're in.
Those Twix bars are dead.
Sit here, you have
those Twix bars are dead.
They have to deal with the low ramp people.
That's the medical copy of it. Actually, you want to sign and seal this? The matter will be ready for what the chairman signs.
Is it the, which seal is it?
This is the county. Yeah.
Yeah. All these from chairman?
These are all from the chairman.
Good. I'm going to say.
Excellent.
Let's blow it. Non-important.
This is like the Muppets. Remember those two, the Muppets, those two old crashy guys sticking up there?
That's Pete and Brian. They're crotchety.
No, that's crotchety.
Firing down.
Are you signing this or not?
You're not the chairman.
He thinks he is.
Stop it already.
Ah, you guys are fired up today. What's in the water?
Oh, my goodness. Ain't picking on me, boy. I'm picking on everybody.
That's all right. If you dish it out, you got to be able to take it, right?
If I put this out, I would have covered up
with
it.
So,
you try.
So, do you know Lee Crow? She's Ann Crow's daughter.
You maybe not why.
I was curious.
You're correct. We are
going to
rename this to.
Stop becoming sensitive to the
language.
The
one thing is.
You ready?
Blue tabs. Blue tabs. Only, not red tabs?
No, those should be for Andrew.
How are you doing?
I'm doing pretty well.
I'm doing pretty well. This is a guy, as well as a guy.
Does everybody have to sign this, or just if you
know? I don't know.
Chairman.
Just the chairman.
Oh, really? It's perfect.
Yeah.
Yeah, those are just the things that are on the app.
Yes.
Thank
you.
Try my best to get that done.
Send it to you. Send it to you.
individual copies of that, so you just flip the pages. Basically, what this is the notice that basically says, it's a notice to the district attorney that says, we want to issue these bonds or file suit against us.
And make to allow us or to make us show the documents?
Yeah, basically.
That's kind of like executive session. I mean, sometimes the best thing that can happen is we get sued.
Yeah.
And it's because then we can go to executive session.
Right. First two, you're all three blue tabs.
Just all blues or just the first two?
Just first two blues. First wave papers, anyways, right?
All right, that's where I stopped.
Okay, perfect. You're free at last.
Free at last.